Greetings and hellos to the Bitwig community and beyond. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the note editor and how we edit MIDI notes in MIDI clips. And keeping in stride with Bitwig's workflow, the note editor is designed to be very fast and easy and offers a number of shortcuts that never interrupt your flow. So let's take a look at how all of this works. So the first thing that we'll want to do is we'll want to set up our MIDI controllers, and we do this from settings. So if we go to controllers, and if we haven't already set up our MIDI controller, we have the add controller button down at the bottom. And once we hit this, it brings up a couple of fields where we can select what the hardware vendor is. And once we find what we want from our list, it then shows us a list of the different controller options that we can use. And we simply hit the add button, and that adds it into our controller list. The next thing that we'll want to do is we'll want to go to our audio preferences, and we'll want to adjust our block size to a low enough size so that we have good timing and response from when we strike on our MIDI controller. So I generally keep mine at 128 samples, and this is usually low enough to provide a very good response. But if the project becomes big and I start to see a CPU strain, I can always increase my block size and raise my latency. And finally, the last place I want to go is to behavior, and I want to make sure that note chase is checked if it's not checked. And what this does is this will actually trigger MIDI notes if we start playback in the middle of the note. So for long sustaining notes like pads and chords, the note chase will trigger the notes even if we don't start from the very beginning of it. So once we have that set up, let's go ahead and record a new MIDI clip. I have a drum beat in this project, and I'm going to use the polymer to record a bass line. And there's a couple of different places that I can record MIDI clips. I can record into the clip launchers, or I can record into the arranger timeline. But for this example, I'm going to record into the arranger timeline. So let's go ahead and record a bass part against this drum beat. Now, if we double click on the MIDI clip, it brings up the detail editor panel at the bottom. And just as with editing audio, I can also use the full screen real estate and use the edit panel layout, which gives us a full window display for our note editor. And I can also use the shift tab key to switch back and forth very quickly between the arranger timeline and the edit panel layout. So once we're in the note editor, the left-hand side over here shows us the musical keyboard, and the center shows the notes as they fall against the musical grid. And if we need to change the resolution, that's located down at the bottom right-hand corner here, and we can go ahead and change the resolution. It's set at 16th notes now by default. And there may be certain situations where when I jump into the note editor, we're either too far zoomed out or too far zoomed in. And there's a very easy way to fix that. I can go ahead and simply hit Command A to select all of the notes and hit the Z key. And that basically zooms in all the way so that I can see exactly what I'm working on. Now, just like with editing audio, we have a variety of different tools that we can use to perform different operations. But for many of those edits, though, the pointer tool can do double or triple duty. Now, with the pointer tool, I can click and drag notes. And you hear that there's feedback when I click on the note, so I hear what it is. And down at the bottom, I have an audition notes button that I can toggle on and off. And I'm going to turn this off just so that it doesn't drive you crazy and me crazy as I do this. But with the pointer tool, I can click and drag notes. I can extend the end of a note or the beginning of it. I can also double click to erase notes, and I can double click to create notes as well. Now with the pen tool, I can draw notes in just as I do by double clicking. But if I hold down the Alt or Option key before I start drawing in, it's going to create individual notes at each division of the grid. And if I drag up or down vertically, it's going to change the velocity of those notes. So this can be very, very handy for doing drum rolls and quick note entry things that we'd want to have. And there's another wrinkle in the midst of all of this as well. If I hold the Alt key and start drawing in notes, I can then hold the Shift key and it will allow me to vertically, dragging up and down, change the pitches of the notes that are being entered. So this is a very fast way to enter different note sequences. And I almost equate it to the way that a step sequencer would work. So let's just Command Z to undo all of that. I can copy notes by clicking and holding the Alt or Option key and dragging. I can also select a MIDI note and hit the Command D button to duplicate it over and over and over again. And in many situations, I want to copy a specific range that might include some blank spaces and all. So I can simply select the entire range that I want to copy and then hit the Command D button to copy that range with blank spaces and all. So let's undo this. And there'll often be times where we don't necessarily want to see the entire piano roll. So we have two different views that we can look at. We can look at the piano roll, which is what we're looking at, which includes all the notes, or we can use the drum editor view, which is only going to show us the notes where there is MIDI information. And we can use the F on the QWERTY keyboard to flip back and forth between the drum editor and the piano roll. Now there are many more operations that we can perform that are accessible from the note menu up at the top. So I'm going to go ahead and erase some of the notes that I had put in here, and I'm going to go ahead and put this second note back down to where it was when I recorded it. And I'm going to hit Command A to select all of the notes so that any of the operations that we perform are going to be affecting the notes. So from the drop-down menu, the first one that we're going to take a look at is Quantize, and this is going to allow us to correct the timing when we record live MIDI material in. So I'm going to go ahead and hit this, and it brings up a dialog box, and it allows me to choose the grid resolution that we want to use. So we're going to choose 16th notes, and I can quantize at the start and at the end. And if I choose the end, then what it's going to do is it's simply going to make each of those notes be the exact length of one of the divisions of 16th notes. So let's not quantize the end, just the start, and let's say OK. And voila, everything is now quantized. I'm going to go ahead and go back to the piano roll. And the next thing that we can do is we can transpose notes up a semitone, down a semitone, up an octave, or down an octave. And we can perform this from this note menu, but it's actually something that we can do from the arrow keys on our QWERTY keyboard. So if I have all the notes or any number of the notes selected, I can use the up arrow key to transpose up semitones and down semitones. And if I hold the Shift key, it will throw the notes an octave higher or octave lower, depending on if I go up or go down. I can also scale notes. And I can do this from the note menu, but I can actually do it faster using a modifier key, the Alt key. So I can do this to individual notes where if I hold down the Alt key when I'm at the tail end of it or at the beginning of it, it's going to allow me to scale it. And I can also scale a range of notes as well. So if I select multiple notes and I go to the edge of the range and I hold down the Alt Option key, I can scale the entire range using the left side as the anchor. And from the note menu, I can also perform legato. And what this is going to do, let me just select all of the notes. This is going to make the end of the note extend to the start of the next one. So if I click on this, everything is all neat and tidy, and this is actually very useful for pads and for textures or notes that were just a little bit too short when we hit them. Velocity for notes can be accessed at the bottom of the screen, right here. And if I use the pen tool, I can draw in the velocities for my different notes. And if I hold down the Alt or Option key, I can go ahead and make velocity ramps. And if I am hovering over a note with the pointer tool, I can hold down the Command and Shift keys, and I can adjust the velocity for each independent note. without having to go down to the bottom to adjust it in the velocity editor. And finally, I can use colors to display specific attributes of notes. And if I right-click on the piano roll, we have note color options. And by default, we've been looking at everything in clip. And what this is showing us is notes that are the same color as the clip, but they become paler as the velocity is lower and more intense and vibrant as the velocity is higher. Note channel is going to filter and change the color based on the MIDI channel, and this is very useful for working with MPE material, where we're working with different MIDI channels in the same clip. Pitch class is going to change the color of the clips depending on what the pitch is. And the final one is velocity. And again, this is going to change the color based on the velocity. So as you can see, the note editor and editing functions are very straightforward and deeply intertwined into Bitwig's workflow, making editing functions very fluid and very natural. And hopefully, if you are new to Bitwig, this video has provided you with most, if not all, of the answers to how MIDI note data is edited. And if you've already been using Bitwig, hopefully this has opened your eyes to a couple of functions that might have slipped through the cracks that you might not have noticed the first time. So until next time, thanks for listening and stay creative.